Hello guys, what is going on? It's your boy Corbin, aka FatalScripting here, and welcome back to another Dark Souls 3 walkthrough. At this point, we will be moving on to the Undead Settlement level. So, after beating Bort of the Boreal Valley, we will walk down here and raise that banner, raise it into the air, raise it and praise the sun. Let's praise it. And look at that, another bonfire right after a bonfire. The amount of bonfires that are in Dark Souls 3 is ridiculous. But this is going to be dog central, y'all. I'm warning y'all right now, if you don't like the dogs so far, then you're really going to hate this area. Upon coming down here. Let's see if we can sneak up behind these doggos. Ah, can't. Go ahead and grab these alluring skulls. And come down here. This is where the real cream of the pot is, right here. Go ahead and come over here. Two homeward bones right there, and then if I can get through these turtle, this one will talk to you. This one.
Please,
grant me death. Undo my shackles. Sorry. Talk to him.
I am some, well, perhaps, eh? I was what?
And accept his service. And he will travel to the Firelink Shrine, she, her, him, they, it, I don't know, I don't care. But it will travel to the Firelink Shrine, giving you 5 free level ups as long as your hollowing is at above 16. If it's not, just kill yourself. Quite literally, or have someone else kill you. Your hollowing level raises by dying, so if your hollowing level isn't 20 for some reason, and then just kill yourself several times, and you'll get the hollowing level you need. These will also kill the enemies though, so you want to let them kill some of those. Those enemies won't attack you normally either way, so they're not really a hassle. I'm just gonna kill these dogs, because I fucking hate dogs. God, I hate them with passion. This dude's gonna close the door on you because he's a dick. Just pull the lever. And just, can you parry this dude actually? Yes, you can. Alrighty, good to know. Never tried parrying that dude before. But go ahead and come hit this bonfire, which, look at that, another bonfire. And we're going to go ahead and travel back to the Firelink Shrine real quick. Go ahead and level up, use our boss soul, and do what we need to do. Alrighty. Upon coming here, go ahead and consume all the souls you need to. All these ones you picked up, all those little baby ones. And then this is a boss soul. You can use boss souls once you beat the optional boss to use and sell, and you'll get boss weapons from it. Although the Boreal Valley Bort does not give you very good weapons whatsoever, so we're going to go ahead and consume his soul. Give us a free, what, 20? 2? 2,000 souls. That was a lot less than I thought. We're gonna go ahead and come over here. Can we reinforce weapons? Still not. Okay. Well, we're gonna go ahead and infuse our current weapon, and you're gonna want to infuse it with other refined. No, not refined actually, because it doesn't even affect it. So infuse it with raw. That's gonna go ahead and give you that 183 damage. That will completely eliminate enemies. Down here, you'll find that first dude that we unlocked from the cell tower. As you can see, you can purchase items from him. Daggers, long swords, bastard swords, crossbows, fire arrows, which are one of my favorite arrows. Fire bombs. Those are extraordinarily helpful. And then coming over here is where our Yol is. If you, like I said, if you have over, you can purchase items from her, spells, if you want to do a little witchcraft. But here's what we're doing. Draw out your true strength. It will give you 5 free levels up to, until... If your hollowing is above 16, it will give you 5 free levels. So, kind of nice to have. Go ahead and do that first one. We're going to put in strength.
Be safe, champion of...
Oh, okay. So you start off with a 20 hollowing, and you need to die several more times. So just keep her with you, my bad, that was on me. You need to raise your hollowing by 16. In other words, if you start off the game with 20 hollowing, you'll need to get it to 16.
Well,
To 36, actually. Go ahead and raise that to 20. Get 18 on that. Actually, I have plenty of... Let's do one in strength. And I don't believe I have anything else. No? Alright. So, we can go ahead and travel back to that bonfire. Alright, from here, people around, there's anything over here? No? Alright. So from here, we can move on. All those dogs and everything are still there. They won't fuck with you, though. Come to this doorway, we will find two more enemies here. So be careful. Ah, they will gang up on you. Ah, you know, I hate enemies that gang up on you. Really pestersome. But if I'm correct, it's not a barn to fire too far away, so I'm not too worried. Go ahead and come down these steps and grab this charcoal pine bundle, roll, but there's an enemy right here, and this guy will do mass amounts of damage to you and just completely screw you over. Upon dropping down here, we can go ahead and grab two more charcoal pine bundles. Ew, God. Be ready to block it once again, because there's two more, and another one right here. These dudes are a pain in the ass. They have long range, short range, they do mass amounts of damage, and it's really fucking irritating. But not as irritating as this next area we're going into. Now this area, bam. Now this probably looks pretty intimidating to you. I know it did to me, but is not as bad as it seems. Just start over here, pick one off at a time. Just slowly make your way around. This will get annoyingly difficult at a certain point, but now is not that point. This guy will may aggro you. Take him out. And then once you get right here, that's when the annoyingness comes in. Because this witch will aggro you. And this chick is the biggest... Oh! Yeah, if she starts opening that book like that, get out of her way. She will shoot a spell at you. And it... It'll, like, it's like a fiery hug, it will hurt. She doesn't have very much health, it's pretty easy to kill. But she does mass amounts of damage. And will poison you as well. So, kill these enemies, go ahead and grab this Estus shard right here, gonna get us another health potion. Come running over here, we're gonna go ahead and grab this. Soul of Unknown Traveler. Around here, another pitchaxe dude. Grab this soul, I believe. No ember, nice. Okay. There's an item over there, so we're gonna go ahead and drop down. Drop a pickaxe dude. That's a pain in the ass. Do that here. You made me fall, you dick. There's a titanite shard. Okay, that'll give us plus two. Be careful, these guys will destroy you. There's really no point in coming down here. I've never been. Actually, you know what? I've never been down here. Let's check this out. This is somewhere you don't want to be right now. Let's just keep it at that. This is for a secret covenant. You don't... We will mess with this at another time. You don't really need that. That area is... When I say that area is optional, that area is very optional. It's literally, there's nothing you need in that area whatsoever. Nothing helpful whatsoever either. So we're just gonna go ahead and not mess with that area right now. And just continue on. So speaking of continuing on, we're gonna go ahead and come around here. Ooh. This guy's throwing fire bombs.
Oh hell no!
Did that really just happen again? so sorry about y'all, that y'all, in case you didn't notice or didn't see in the first video or second video, that is actually what happened to me. That's why you can see all the items I was picking up. It's because my internet just zipped out. I don't know if that's my internet, the Dark Souls servers. I don't really know what's going on with that, but it's really a pain in the ass. I'm already not dealing with you today, bucko. That, yeah, okay, well, apparently I have to. Because I suck at parrying. Can I just get good, please? There we go. You're a dick. Fuck you. Work trousers. And then before continuing on that way, we're gonna come this way. I believe there's a ring right over here. Yeah, so there's like a little shortcut if you don't, if you have a ring that it negates fall damage. Dab it in the butt. What else did I do? Oh, shit. Forgot about you. Go ahead and grab this. Oh! Actually, is there anything over here? Okay. You're gonna piss me off. Oh, shit. Alrighty then. We're just gonna go ahead and continue on then. Maybe this is. Maybe I'm thinking of a different area. I don't know. I could have swore there was a ring there. If there is a ring there, I'm missing it, y'all. I'm so sorry. I could have swore there was, but it doesn't look like there is, though. I could have swore there was, though. Ugh, when they only have like one hit left with the backstab them anyway, taking forever. Alright. Continue on. They're gonna run into one of these things again. This one is not quite as easy as the other one. This thing takes a lot more damage, and when it hits you, it does a lot more damage. Trust me. You do not want to get hit by that. But from here, we are now here. Pretty cool, right? Here we go. Now we're... yeah, see? Yeah, you can fucking... fuck off. Go ahead and grab this Catechus Round Shield. Is that better than the one I have, actually? Didn't I bring up a Lothric Night Shield? Yeah, we're actually going to grab this Lothric Night Shield. Can you parry with this? Yeah, you can. Okay. We're going to go ahead and throw that on as well. Actually, I don't really like the way that looks. I'm just going to keep it off. Forget it. I like the way I look. I think I'm cute. Y'all think I'm cute? I'm pretty sure I'm cute. Okay. So first up, we're going to roll off the edge right here. Roll off the edge right here. Grab this Titanite Shard. Heal real quick, please and thank you. And continue moving onwards. The reason I want to drop down here is because, bam, bonfire. And who doesn't love a bonfire? Go ahead and rest at that and continue on. Go ahead and come up here. And those guys that were throwing firebombs are now dead-o. Well, actually not quite. Now they are dead-o. There's also a pyromancer here.
Uh-huh. Well, I have got him. I hear Geralt.
Ask to Empowerment. He will also travel to Firelink Shrine and allow you to buy and purchase pyromancies. So it's pretty cool. Hand axe, not the best weapon, not bad though. There's worse. And then from here, we're just gonna want to roll off. Bam, bam, perfect. Come over here, you're gonna grab this Soul of Unknown Traveler, and then rolling down here, we're gonna grab one of my least favorite rings in the game. Thank you, the Fire Clutch Ring. I'm not a huge fan of anything that makes you take more damage. Did that dude come to life? Okay. Of anything that makes you take more damage, so I don't like this ring, but increases fire attack, but compromises damage absorption. You know, I'm not a huge fan of that, but I know some people probably would be, so I'll show you where it is anyway. And then there's this dude. This dude is a pain in the ass. He would just continuously smash you with his bucket. Like over and over and over again, and he's just playing. As you can see, pretty easy if you have this sword, but he was a pain in the ass in my first run through. But from here, we're gonna go ahead and heal for safety measures, and also because I'm paranoid about everything. Is there something right here? No, I thought there was. No, okay. Go ahead and kill this dude. Kill these dudes. Run over here. This is a trap over here, so be careful. We're gonna slowly make our way here. Grab this large soul and roll. But as you can see, bam, dude. Alright, perfect. And from here you can see there's another fire chick, and that is to the boss. We're actually not gonna take this path to the boss, so don't worry about going that way at all, really. We're gonna roll down here, doggo. Don't do this to me. There we go. And we are gonna come down here. Son of a fucking... Please, let me hit you. Thank you. God, I hate dogs. Have I said how much I hate dogs yet? Because I really hate them. And down here we got some rats, a giant rat, and a ring. Rats are probably just as annoying as dogs, in my opinion. I hate them. There's a I don't know how to pronounce it. I'm sorry. I failed you all, but... Rip. I'm going to go ahead and take out one of those little baby rats because we're going to have a big mama rat on our ass in a second. That you don't want little rats fucking with you. Upon killing this, you will receive the blood bite ring, which will increase his blood resistance. Blood resistance, in case I don't know, because it is a little bit of a mysterious thing. As you can see, I'm taking blood damage right now. Blood damage is with any weapon, as you can see, that plus 16, plus 17 blood damage is after a certain amount of hits, you will get blood damage, which will take mass amounts of your health and will continue taking mass amounts of your health. So that ring is actually somewhat helpful, especially for this coming up levels, this level and the next. Very helpful. Come through this and you will find yourself another bonfire. Go ahead and rest at it. There is a crystal lizard up there. That's who we're going to go get right now. Go ahead and take this sharp left. And you will also get your first invasion right here as well. Which this guy's probably going to get away from me because I kind of... No, he did not. And as you can see there, he is right there. He is an invader. He is an NPC invader. You can be invaded by actual players and by NPCs. NPCs obviously are slightly easier to handle. I would come over here by the bonfire so that one enemy does not aggro you. And just have him come over here. I would also recommend switching shields to a slightly lighter shield so that you can parry. Oh my god, that was a horrible parry. I'm horrible at NPCs, but I'm horrible at invaders, y'all. I'm sorry. This is going to be a little embarrassing. I'm probably just going to go in here and try to tank this. There you go. Fuck you. That's one way to do it, by the way, y'all. That is one way to do it. Now, over there is mass amounts of loot and the shortcut to the boss fight, but we actually need to do something else before we do that, because we're going to get a sick ring, one of my favorite rings in the game. I've played it through all of my playthroughs, NG plus everything. Go ahead and also lunge attack this thing over here. I'm going to take that out right off the bat, and those. Are you seriously not dead? Please die. And there's a, oh, and because going over there, before you do this, there will be a giant ballista constantly shooting at you, doing mass amounts of damage. But if we go ahead and take this thing out right now, then you will be safe from the ballista. As a matter of fact, it will actually harm the enemies before it harms you. So very helpful. That's what we're gonna do. Right, we're gonna actually walk away right now. We don't want to fuck with that witch. Not right now, we don't. We're gonna wait a second. If she's still there, I guess we can try to fight her, but... Oh, God. Oh, God. Oh, God. Not gonna fight her right there? No, we're not. Just walk away, dude. Walk away. Look at your ugly looking face. Walk away. Walk away. Walk away. Alright, dickwad. Yeah, your fat ass can't get in here. Oh, god damn it. I spoke too soon. Holy shit. Okay, I'm sorry I called you fat. I didn't mean it. That dog was gonna come after me. Ah! Walk on, please. Okay. Do I need to buy a pilot now? Is this bitch really still there? Son of... Oh no, that attack. God, I fucking hate that thing. I'm gonna take that bitch out. Fuck you. Man, fuck you. Alright. We got some fuck boys to take care of over here. I'd recommend just getting this guy to come by himself real quick. Those who are a pain in the ass, take care of as it is. They will actually, these ones will actually throw their pots at you. Oh, almost throw them off a cliff. Oh, god, not good. Okay. Let's just walk away for a second. Go ahead and grab that. Taking on two of these guys at one time is always a pain in the ass, so I'm going to throw some fire bombs at one of them. Oh my god, bad idea. Well, that one just completely offed himself. I mean, I'm cool with that, that's what you want to do. God, these guys just spam their saws. Thank you for dying. Shit. Okay. Okay, so let's go ahead and... this guy, we can talk to him, you cannot, it doesn't really matter, just click that button and roll off the elevator, making it go back down. Otherwise, typically it's just a single path straight down, but doing this it will allow you to take it up, because this one will come up, and you can take it up. Once the elevator gets all the way up, go ahead and get off, come up here, and there will be a giant right here, which we will be killing later in the game for a ring, but for now, make peace. Go ahead and make peace with it for now. That way, he's the one shooting the ballistas. That way, whenever he shoots, he will not completely ruin your fucking day. Because trust me, he will ruin your day. Or night, or evening, or whenever you like to play. Personally, I'm a nighttime player. I don't know about y'all. Alright, we were actually coming back over to this area for that ring I was talking about. But for now, we are going to just continue onwards. You can kill that dude for his hammer if you want. I'm not going to. There's no reason to right now. Be kind of mean. I don't want to be mean to the dude. He's kind of chill, I guess. You're spasming over there. You're kind of creeping me out a little. The only thing about this is we're actually going to... what's it called? Open up the boss fight area from here. So I went to... How many undead... yeah, we have plenty of homeward bonds. So we're just going to go ahead and clear out this area over here, open up the boss area, and then homeward bone it back to this bonfire. And what's it called? We'll go ahead and clear out that next area and then head to this boss. This boss is actually an optional boss, so you don't have to kill him. I would highly recommend doing it, though, as this boss allows you to take any other boss's souls. And get their weapon from it. So, like I said, I would recommend doing that. Go ahead and take you out, because you are a pain in my asshole. And then we can now come over to this area. This is where we'll be getting our first undead bone shard and a bunch of other cute little things. As you can see, this ballista would normally attack you. You'll see in a second, but now it attacks the enemy. Watch. Bam! Haha, you're dead. There's a decent amount of enemies over here. As you can see, there's about four of them over here. And some in the building right there. This ballista should take care of all of them, though. I'm going to take care of that one first, obviously. Hey, thanks for the help, Ballista. Not that I, you know, already killed him or anything. There we go. Go ahead and grab the reinforced club. Whatever the hell he dropped. Young White Branch. Young White Branch. Solo Deserted Corpse, and we will come and jump across this gap and grab our first Undead Bone Shard. Undead Bone Shards will increase the, I don't want to say potency, but I don't know any other word for it, so potency of your Estus Flasks, which will allow it to heal you more than usual. It will say a normal Estus Flask gives you 100 health, this will give you 150 health. That is not accurate, it is an example though. Come over here, grab the cleric stuff, be ready for this guy to drop on you like a fucking... Oh, this is that, it's that pain in the ass you don't want to fuck with. This guy don't play. As you can see, we don't want to go into a boss fight at this low of health as it is, so... And grab Mordekin's Ashes. Mordekin's Ashes will, I believe, allow you to buy Titanite Shards and several other items from the Maiden. You just go and give it to her, and she will have different items to sell you. These dudes are also pain in the ass just because they're purely off their movement speed. They're not that much, you know, not very strong, don't have a lot of health, but they move extraordinarily fast if you let them. From here, we're going to go ahead and try to jump across this thing. Oh, I missed miserably. That was actually terrible. Go ahead and... Wow, I can't see where the edge is at. Am I blind? Hold on, let me look. Oh, yeah, I'm blind. Okay, wow, that's great to know. There we go. Go ahead and roll across and grab this. It usually will give you the Great Sky. Not a bad dex build for the beginning, I guess. Never really use it too much, though. Go ahead and run up here. And this is where the boss fight is. Once again, this is an optional boss. Don't go against it if you don't want to. I'm going to, though. Go ahead and keep on swimming. Keep on swimming. And this is actually the door right here that... You'll see where I'm talking about in a second. As you can see, this is the door that leads to that area that I said we can just walk up these stairs and come here, but we're not going to. This is the door that leads there. So we're going to go ahead and use our Homeward Bone, use Bonfire Last Rested. And from here, we're going to go back across the sewers with the giant rat, back across the throne pot fucks. We don't have to fight them, though. I'm just going to run through those, because I don't need to fight them more than once. And we will then... go to that area I was just talking about. So from here, let's just go ahead and go back across. We'll keep the Minecraft Grim Reaper. I didn't even attack it. Great. Son of a... Okay. Well, these will apparently drop souls of deserted corpses. So, there are some souls. Hopefully we don't get stuck with that witch again. If so, I'm just going to have to kill her quite quickly. This episode, I'm pretty sure, is already dragging on longer than it should be. I'm a creeper. My walkthrough episode will probably be a little bit longer because I don't... Like, a lot of them have, like, every single place and every single thing written down on his paper. I'm just kind of going off memory right now. So, I mean, not that my memory's bad or anything. I have beaten the game, you know, 9+ times. My memory's not horrible, but... Still going off memory, so nonetheless. Now, as I said, we're gonna run across these enemies as best as possible. Just keep on running, keep on running, keep on running, keep on running, 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 running. And go ahead and grab this and take it up. Now, halfway from rolling up, you'll see a board plank. Roll off on it, and come over here. You will see this onion dude from Dark Souls 1. Just talk to him a couple times, and you will see what you'll have to fight, and this is why I wanted to the bonfire first, because of that. This Demon King is what you'll be fighting right now. Just go ahead and start attacking it, and within a couple of seconds, the onion guy will come over and practically kill it for you if you want. You can just stay away from it. I'm going to probably help him, though. Actually, I'm probably... I might help him. Yeah, because I'm going to want to level up before I go to the boss anyway, so... Don't mind using a homeward bone real quick, but... Oh. I might die from this, actually. Heal. Oh shit! Don't look at me. Don't look at me. Please don't look at me. Why'd you look at me? Dead. Especially gives you a good amount of souls. 5,000 souls and a fire gem, which will apply fire to Bright Heaven weapon. Go ahead and talk to him before you leave. Sigbrau. Give you some, it's kind of like a little mini health potion in a bottle right there. Well, health potions are in bottles. You get the point, though. You can kill him for his armor and weapon if you want. I believe you get the Storm Ruler, which is a early access weapon that will be used to defeat a boss later on in the game, but you don't really need it, so I'm not going to worry about it. Grab the large club. Come over here. Go ahead. Grab this, which is the Northern Helm. This is weapon use. That's the armor you start off with as a warrior anyway, so kind of useless to us. And then if you roll and jump, go ahead and drop that, and this will give you the Pale Tongue that will be used for Rosaria's things later on in the game. So from here, we're going to go ahead and go in here, come over here, grab some dung piles, I believe, red bug pellet, I am completely wrong, not even more wrong, come up these stairs, come around, oh. I would not say what is back there is very worth it. Before this playthrough, I'm going to grab it. Alluring Skulls. I wouldn't recommend killing those things. They're just a pain in the ass and will kill you without a second thought. So I wouldn't recommend doing it. Coming around here, there will be two dogs. Still biggest pain in the asses ever. And then a chest right here. Roll, because these enemies are gonna spawn in. Like I said, pain in the asses. They don't have too much health, but if you get anywhere near them, they just kind of all hit you. And then if you stay too far away, they'll shoot those dung piles at you. As you can see, god, pain in the asses. But kill those, come over here and you can grab the human pine resin. I believe that that's poison or dark to your weapon, I cannot remember which one. And then up here there are two witches. I do not recommend killing these. If you want to, go right ahead. I am not, because I am already incredibly low on health, so run. And I'm already pretty sure I'm going to get screwed over doing this anyway from fall damage. But I'm going to do it for the vine. Come over here, grab Flynn's ring. Not a bad ring. It, low ring equipment load increases attack. I'm actually going to switch Bloodbite for that because I don't have a very high equipment load on this right now. And then from here, I'm probably actually going to use that health potion you just gave me because I'm already out of essence for some reason. Come down here, roll. And if you have Estus and you're good, don't use this. I'm going to because for the sake of the fact that I don't want to freaking die. Grab these homeward bones. And then this is where we get that ring. Now, if you miss this jump, you die. There's literally no other way of saying that, so... I'm gonna go ahead and cut it till I get back. Alright, y'all, I am back after, you know, death, so... Go ahead and roll off from the edge, that's where I messed up, and we are back. Okay. Right here is the Mira Vest, Mira Gloves, and Mira Trousers, not the best, but here's what we're really after. The Chlorinthi Ring. This ring raises stamina recovery speed. Doesn't sound very good, but is personally one of my favorite. Alright, y'all, so. Okay. I messed up again. In which I, kind of left 16,000 souls at the top of that. I forgot to pick them up. So, I'm gonna go grab those. Once again, be right back. Alrighty, y'all. We are back. This is right after we grab the Clarinthi ring, and those are the stairs to the boss fight in which the storage door should already be open. So from here, I would recommend going ahead and using consuming your souls first or second, doesn't really matter. And we can go ahead and use a homeward bone and go level up real quick, upgrade our sword, do what we need to do, and then come back and go ahead and take out that boss. Upon defeating this boss, we'll be going back to one area, and then we'll be on to the next area, and that will be the end of this episode. Go ahead and level up. Grab a point in dex to grab endurance, grab that. Go ahead and, oof. Grab one vitality, might as well. I mean, nah. Gonna put that in vigor. Come over here. Believe we should be able to upgrade. Give these umbrella ashes to her. Bleeding now by, no, I don't know. I don't know what that added, actually. Gonna go ahead and need a torch. Buy a torch. You're gonna need a torch. Trust me, you're gonna need a torch. We're gonna go ahead and upgrade our weapon. Reinforce Estus flasks. Yes. And that's for the pyromancers, by the way. I forgot to bring that up. Pyromancers right there. So go ahead and reinforce your Estus flasks. I believe we only had one, right? Yes. And then right here at the bonfire is where you can actually burn your undead bone shard, giving you Estus flasks plus one. And then from here, go ahead and travel back to the dilapidated bridge. And this is where we'll be taking on the un-something, hollow something. It's a giant tree. I'm probably going to call in a summon for this one. Just because, well, no, I won't call in a summon. I kind of wanted to because it would speed it up a little bit. And, it would speed it up and it would, make it to where, because this boss is a little bit more of a pain in the ass because it has like a bunch of smaller enemies surrounding it. But forget that, we'll just go ahead and take it on solo so I can show y'all how to handle it solo. If, say, you have to play offline or something. Let's go ahead and run past all these enemies. No need to take them on again. We got a boss coming up right here. They're probably going to follow you. No, they're not actually. I was wrong. This is where the boss fight is. Am I embered up? That I am, that I am. And this is where the boss fight is. I would recommend equipping these four things you have right here. And before you get too close to that tree, which is the boss fight, take out some of these enemies around them because trust me, it will help lots. By this point, this should all be one hits, so it shouldn't be too bad. Especially these red-eyed ones. Okay. Now you see those ball sacks on it? Those ball sacks are what you're aiming for. Watch out for its beads. Don't notice that. I did not get hit. No, I did not. Go ahead and roll out of the way of this. It's gonna cover the floor with poison. Go ahead and get out of the way of it. Not, don't do what I did. I did bad. And what you're gonna wanna do is you're just gonna attack these ball sacks. There will be mass damage, and then upon explosion, they will really mess it up. Yeah, he has ball sacks all around his body. Just keep a lookout for him. And then once you destroy a couple of them, actually, I guess one, I don't know. He's gonna go ahead and fall down here where he grows another ball sack with an arm sticking out of it. Be careful, for some of these attacks tend to be pretty deadly to you. Like that one. I've never even been attacked by this before. I'm so scared. Okay, that was not as bad as I thought it was going to be. But see, like I said, this boss fight can be pretty tedious if you don't have a summon with you. That's why I was going to bring a summon. I probably should have. Yeah, I'm going to take that out. He does have one right here. I'll be careful for those. Another ball sack down. Okay, get this one on this leg. Dead. Oh god, no. There we go, there's that one. And then he also has one on his back that I don't find very very good idea to attack, but you're probably gonna have to. And there you go, the Cursed Rotted Greatwood is defeated. Go ahead and grab this, one more bone right here. And War God Shield. And from here you have beaten this, whatever you want to call this. So now we are going to go ahead and go back to the Stipulated Bridge, and move on to the next area, which will go ahead and wrap up this level. I am personally going to run through all of these enemies again. Once again, if you don't want to run through all of them, that is fine. You don't have to. You can kill them if you want. But I personally do not care to do this tedious procedure over and over again. So I am going to just run past them. Go ahead and hop this ladder. There is actually one more slightly annoying enemy boss. Mini boss is actually what I can think of what it's considered. That you'll have to face before moving on to the next area that I just forgot about to tell y'all. Sorry. It happens. But let me warn y'all, it is a pain in the ass of a mini-boss. This mini-boss we're going to be going against just moves so incredibly fast and does such mass amounts of damage. Just have a pretty stable shield on you is all I can really say. Now we're going to come back to this elevator and go ahead and take it down. Good boy, don't come down here with me. Go ahead and roll off right here because I'm lazy. Probably shouldn't have done that. Okay. And here is this mini boss I was telling you about. It is a Frost Knight. It is a pain in the ass is a better way to say it. You will see what I mean in a second. It doesn't look too bad right now, right? Oh, yeah, it's... Oh, that's bad. There's no parrying it. There's no backstabbing it. There's no... Since it is, you know, a Frost Knight, I'm going to go ahead and pre-assume that it's weak to fire. I can't guarantee that to y'all, though. Just my guess. Ah, God, the thing is so relentless. There we go. See, it doesn't have that much health, but it still is a pain in the ass. But killing it will reward you the Irithyll Straight Sword, which you need a 14 dex to use it. It's one of the better swords. I'm personally going to stick with the Raw Sword just because I love the Asura. It's my baby. But it is definitely one of the better weapons, and this is also definitely one of the harder mini-bosses. But that's actually going to be it for this level. This is the Bonfire to the Road of Sacrifices, which will be the beginning of the next level. If this did help you out, do not forget to leave a like, and do not be afraid to hit that subscribe button. If you have any feedback for me, leave it in the comment sections below. If I missed anything, also leave that in the comment sections below. Otherwise, this has been Will Corbin, aka Photoscriptor. Peace out.